स्वच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बू मुद्रिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नकाः. We finished the first Udyotam and starting the second Udyotam. In this, he talks about the different classifications of Dhvani and as a topic in between, he talks about Rasavadalankara and the difference between Rasavadalankaram and Dhvani and the placement of Guna Alankara, etc. in the Dhvani structure. So when we spoke about the Kavya Shariram, you had Shabda and Artha are the Shariram of the Kavyam, and there is Guna, Alankara, Riti, Vritti, etc., etc. So in this, he will also talk about some of the placements of where they are. So he starts off with the two divisions, the main divisions of Dhvani, which is Avivakshita Vachyadhvani and Vivakshita Anyapara Vachyadhvani. In the first Udyotam, we saw two examples. One was for Avivakshita Vachyadhvani and the other was for Vivakshita Anyapara Vachyadhvani. Just as a precursor, he showed us that there are two divisions of Dhvani in the first Udyotam. Now in the second Udyotam, he will give us examples, further divisions of Avivakshita Vachyadhvani. Avivakshita Vachyadhvani is divided into Arthantara Sankramitam and Atyanta Tiraskritam. Vivakshita Anyavara Vachyadhvani also has two different sections, which is two divisions, which is Asamlakshikramadhvani and Samlakshikramadhvani. So in the Asamlakshikramadhvani, when he first defines that, Asamlakshikramadhvani is Rasa, Bhava, Rasadhvani, Bhavadhvani, etc., etc. There he talks about the difference between Rasavadalankara and Rasadhvani. What constitutes Rasavadalankaram and how it cannot be Rasadhvani. There are two divisions again for Rasavadalankara. So as a side topic, you still have to, he looks at Rasavadalankaram there, and then Guna Alankaranam Swarupa Pradarshanam. Then he deals with Samlakshikramadhvani. Samlakshikramadhvani also has three divisions. It has three divisions, Shabda Shakti, Artha Shakti, and Ubhe Shakti. Each one of those are divided into three, Kavi Praudhukti, Swata Sambhavi, and Kavi Nibaddha Vaktru Praudhukti. Further, Vastuna Vastu, Vastuna Alankaraha. There are other divisions also of Dhvani. He is not going to go into a detailed division and detailed udaharanam for each and every aspect, like how it is dealt with in Kavya Prakasham. For that sort of enlisting, you need to go to Kavya Prakasham and study that. Here he will deal with it in a more with relevance to how to establish Dhvani. That is his main goal more than anything. So it will be more of a discussion type. We'll start with the text now. Evam avivakshita vachya vivakshita anyapara vachyatvena dhvanihi dviprakarakah dviprakarah prakashitah. So in the prathama udyotam, he said that dhvani is divided into avivakshita vachya dhvani and vivakshita anyapara vachya dhvani, where he gave the examples of, for avivakshita vachya dhvani enna sonnar, suvarna pushpam prithivim, and then Shikarini Kvanunama. These were the two examples that he gave. So for Avivakshita Vachyadhvani, it was Suvarna Pushpam Prithivim, Chinvanti Purushastrayaha, Shurascha Kritavidyascha, Yascha Janati Sevitum. For Vivakshita Anyapara Vachyadhvani, he gave the example of Shikarini Kvanunama, Kiyachiram Kimabhidhanam Asau Akarottapaha, Taruni, Yenatava Adharapatalam, Dashati Bimbapalam, Shukashavakaha. So evam, पूर्वं प्रथम उद्योते अविवक्षित अन्यपरवाच्यत्वेन ध्वनिः द्विप्रकारः इति प्रथम उद्योते प्रकाशितः. तत्र अविवक्षितवाच्यस्य तत्र ध्वनि इन् द टू डिविजन्स् आफ् ध्वनि, अमङ्ग् द टू डिविजन्स् आफ् ध्वनि, अविवक्षितवाच्यस्य प्रभेदप्रतिपादनाय इदम् उच्यते. In order to show the divisions of avivakshitavachyadhvani, he starts arthantare संक्रमितम् अत्यन्तं वा तिरस्कृतम् अविवक्षितवाच्यस्य ध्वनेः वाच्यं द्विधा मतम्. अविवक्षितवाच्यध्वनि इस् ट्रू आफ् टू टैप्स्, वन् इस् अर्थान्तरे संक्रमितम् एण्ड् दि अदर् इस् अत्यन्तं तिरस्कृतम्. दिस् इस् आल्सो काल्ड् लक्षणामूलध्वनि. सो लक्षणा as lakshana moola dhvani, it is not lakshana. So we have seen that discussion about how bhakti hi dhvani hi bhavitum na shaknoti iti. So here arthantare sankramitam. So Rama, if we take the word Rama, we will see that example here. Once we see the example, we will understand what it means. So arthantare ityukte vachyat bhinne vyangye arthe sankramitaha vachyartha. Sankramitaha, it goes and ends, it indicates and it finally ends at the vyangyartham. Just one word could be could lead us to the vyangyartham, or an entire sentence could lead us to the vyangyartham. So arthantare sankramitam atyanta tiraskritam, it means vachyartha is completely let go, it is tyaktam, it is forsaken. So we don't take the vachyartha literally, but we use the vyangyartha more than this, and the vyangyartha is more beautiful than the vachyartha. Tatra arthantara sankramita vachyaha yatha snigdha shyamala kanti litta vyataha nellat malaka dhanaha vata shikarinaha vayoda suhridam ananda kekah kalaha kamam santu dridham kathora hridayo ramosmi sarvam sahe vaidehi tu katham bhavishyati ha 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 devi dhira bhava ityatra ramashabdaha anena vyangya dharmantara parinataha sanyi pratyayate na sanyi matra. Meaning of the shloka is, it is a Rama is talking about, he is describing the Varsha Rutu and saying that the Megha, all the clouds are Snigdha Shyamala. They're very dark in color. The clouds, it's as if they're painting the sky. Lipta Viyataha. The clouds have Lipta. Lipta means Lepanam Kritam. So they have painted the skies. Viyata, the skies are being painted by the Kanti, the luster, which is Snigdha Shyamala, which is thick and dark. So the clouds are so thick and dark that it seems like they have painted the entire sky. Vellat balakaha ghanaha, ghanaha meghaha, balaka, vellat balakaha, vellantaha balakaha yasya. So the clouds are all surrounded by balaka, which is a stork. So the cranes, white cranes are all surrounding the megha. This is a Uddipana Vibhavam for Vipralamba Shringaram. So Rama is separated from Sita here. So the moment he sees the clouds, he is reminded of Sita, and he says he can tolerate this viraham, but he doesn't understand. Kavaidehi to katham bhavishyati ha devi dhira bhava. You have to take courage, you have to be brave and face this rainy season, you have to cross this rainy season without feeling the effect of viraham. Not only are the clouds so dark and ready to pour, vellat balakaha, the cranes are also surrounding the clouds, vataha shikarinaha, there are winds, breeze flowing, and the breeze carries little droplets, shikarinaha. Shikaram is droplets of water. So it's very soothing, and shringarathukku ugandhathu, it's ideal for shringaram, but you are not there. So which means it is a uddipana vibhavam for Vipralamba Shringaram. So vataha shikarinaha, the wind, the breeze is carrying small droplets of water. Winds are carrying droplets of the rain. Payoda suhridam ananda kekaha kalaha. Kalaha ananda kekaha. Payoda suhridam. Payodasya meghasya suhrit mayuraha. Mayuranam ananda kekaha. Ananda kekabdvanihi ativa madhura. So kalaha, the sound that comes from the peacock, the cloud's friends, the peacocks are crying out with the joy. Ananda kekaha. So the keka is a mayura dhvani, is called keka. So the ananda kekaha, the happy sound of the peacocks are also, we are able to hear, which is very sweet. Kalaha. Moment sweet things are heard, you want to spend it with your beloved. Kamam santu dridham kathora hridayaha. It can let it be, you know, it's this kathora hridayaha ramaha. I am Rama, who is a kathora hridaya. He's got a hard-hearted person. I am a very cruel-hearted Rama. he can tolerate everything. Sarvam sahe. I can tolerate everything. Ramosmi. Kathora hridayaha Ramosmi. Sarvam sahe. Vaidehi. The word Vaidehi itself. See, everybody talks about this Rama Shabda in this. Because Rama means... okay, I'll... It's not Dasharatha's son. It is not Kausalya Priti Patram. But it is actually Kathora Hridayaha Ramaha. So you need adjectives which are relevant to the present thing. That is Dukkha Sahanam. He can tolerate any amount of grief. He's a person who has gone with Vishwamitra and fought against all the Rakshasas. And he is also fought with Khara, Dushana and other Rakshasas also in the forest. So he can survive very easily. He can survive this Varsharatu. But Vaidehi is also Arthantra Sankamitam, I feel. I don't know why not many people. So Vaidehi actually means, maybe it is not Arthantra. I'm not sure. Don't take me for it. Just I feel that word is so powerful. She is a person, Sita is a person who has only seen luxury in her life. See, Videha Rajnyaha Putri Esha Vaidehi. She has lived in the palace. From one palace, she has only moved to another palace in Ayodhya. Whereas Rama, even though he was in Ayodhya, he had gone with Vishwamitra, spent the time with him, learned how to face hardships. The question of Bala Atibala Mantram also came because he had to face hunger and everything and fight, right? In the forest, there may be times when they could not get food. So he was given that Mantrapadesham of Bala and Atibala. So Rama has faced so many hardships, but Vaidehi, not Sita, no, Vaidehi. Vaidehi, who is a Videha Rajnyaha Putri, and she has just come here, the Dasharatasya Snusha. So she has only lived in palaces. Sadhu katham bhavishyati, haha devi dhira bhava. I have, you are the one who has to be more courageous during this rainy season, which can kindle that Vipralamba Shrungaram in you. So ityatra Rama shabdaha, Rama iti shabdaha, anena vyangya dharmantara parinataha, samyi pratyayate nyapyate. Samyi, it is not just the Samyi Matram. That is, it is not just Rama, Dasharatasya Putra, or just the person or the Sharira form of Rama. That is not being indicated here. It is the Vyangyartha that is much more important here. 1 minute. Anena Vyangya Dharmantara Parinataha Samyi. Samyi Rama iti Samyi. Vyangya Dharmantara Anyat Dharmena Parinataha Parinamam Praptaha. So that Samyi has transformed itself into all the other Vyangyartha that you can think about. It is a different Dharma that is attributed to the Samyi. Rama is just Samyi. Whereas in the shlokam, that Rama takes on a lot more of visheshana, a lot more of dharma, a lot more of qualities that you can find. All of the, you know, his capability for tolerating grief is being indicated here. It is just not Rama. So that Ramosmi is actually baditam. Because it is Lakshana Muladvani, we have to say that Rama iti padam badhitam Ramosmi. See, no, why should Rama claim that Aham Ramaha Asmi? Nobody would want to say that. Everybody knows Rama here. And if Rama is talking about that viraham, he doesn't need to say Ramosmi. It is actually a vyartham then. No? If you give it to Kavya Prakashagara, he will talk about some dosham there. It's not necessary for Rama to introduce himself and say Aham Ramaha Asmi to himself, right? This is something he talks about the difficulties that Vaidehi will face. He is talking to himself here. So Ramosmi, that is Baditam. He need not introduce himself for himself. So that actually goes to the Lakshyartha, which is Dasharati, or the Vyangyartha, which is because of that Kathora Hridayatvam. Also we have the Vyangyartham of Sahana Shilatvam, Dukkha Sahana Shilatvadi Vengya Dharmantare Parinataha. Very interesting to read the Lochanam in this. Because for each and every word, see, after once you read the whole text, the Ramosmi will give you all the meaning, Vyangyartham that you need and to appreciate. And then you go back to each and every word and you can understand the beauty of that. Snigdhashyamala Kanti Lipta Viyataha. So the Lipta Viyata means the entire sky is completely painted. When you paint, instead of just sticker, see in a paper, if you just take a sticker, black sticker and put it, you can always remove it whenever you want. But if you paint it, it is more difficult and it's more permanent, it's more difficult to remove it. So it's like the akasham is completely painted, vyaptam, sampurnataya vyaptam ityarthaha. So it's even more difficult to look for a white portion and say, okay, let me not focus on the black portion, let me only look at the white portion and feel positive. There is no point, there's no opportunity for that. So he just gives beautiful explanations for each and every word like this. So vataha shikarinaha sukshma jala kana udgarinaha vataha manda mandatvam esham pratiyate manda mandatvam. So it's just shikarinaha means it has small droplets of water which come, so it is more, even more uddipanatvam is there. Okay, next is Yathacha Mamaiva Vishamavana Leelaya. So Mamaiva is Anandavardhana has written Vishamavana Leela, and in that is this shlokam. Tada jayante gunaha yadate sahrdayehi grihyante ravi kirana anugrihitani bhavanti kamalani kamalani. Tada gunaha jayante yada te gunaha sahrdayehi grihyante. Yada, when virtues are gunaha, when qualities are being admired by Sagridaya, when a proper connoisseur, when an ardent rasika comes and enjoys the gunam that is there, take it for example in a kavyam. When you present a kavyam to the correct rasika and they understand, when they appreciate the gunam that is there, that is when gunaha jayante. Tada eva te gunaha iti svikriyante. Just because I have written a kavyam and I keep saying, you know, it has such a great qualities, it is not going to be appreciated. It cannot be called as a great quality or a great poem until it is peer reviewed. So sagradayehi yada gunaha grihyante tada eva gunaha jayante. Only then will virtues blossom if they are admired by men of taste. So ravi kirana anugrihitani kamalani eva kamalani bhavanti. Only those lotuses which have been touched by the rays of the sun. Ravi kirana anugrihitani, ravi kiranaihi sprishtani, surya kiranaihi sprishtani kamalani eva kamalani bhavanti. So they are only those lotuses are lotuses. So here the second word lotus, dvitiyaha kamala shabdaha, it does not just mean kamalam. It actually includes the saurabhatvam, saundaryam, the vikasana yogyatvam, all those things are included there, saukumaryam, everything. So only when the surya kirana touches that lotus, the lotus blooms and it looks more beautiful. The more it blooms, the smell spreads forth. So saurabhatvam, it can be called as a kamalam. It gains a speciality only when it is being touched by the surya kirana. So tada jayante gunaha hidate sahrdayehi grihyante ravi kirana anugrihitani bhavanti kamalani kamalani iti dvitiya kamala shabdaha. Guna shabdaha samgi matram. Okay, kamala shabdaha atra samgi matram nasti dharmantaram api asti. Praninaf pranavantaha. Chala. Yes, யா பிராணினஃப் பிராணவந்தா. ஓகே, அது பெரிய தத்துவமா? இது ரொம்ப சாதாரணமா இருக்கு. திஸ் இஸ் அ வெரி சிம்பிள் கான்செப்ட் ஆஃப் ஹவு யூனோ குணம் ஓன்லி வென் இட் இஸ் அப்ரிசியேட்டட் பை அதர்ஸ் இட் பிகம்ஸ் சோ. இட்ஸ் லைக் சேயிங் யூனோ திஸ் ஷரீரம் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் அ ஷவம் விதவுட் தட் ஆத்மஸ்வரூபம். ஓகே, we move to the next one. Ityatra dvitiyaha kamala shabdaha. Next one, atyanta tiraskritam. So we saw arthantara sankramitam, arthantare sankramitam. But in yaya praninaf pranavantaha, there is no arthantara sankramitam. So you can't say that there is arthantara sankramitam there. Chariya, it's only the meaning that you can apply here. Okay. Atyanta tiras... அத்தியந்த திரஸ்கிருதம் அத்தியந்த திரஸ்கிருதவாச்சியதிகவே வால்மீகே ரவி சங்கராந்த சௌபாக்ய துஷாராவிருத மண்டல நிஷ்வாச அந்தைவ ஆதர்ஷ சந்திரமான பிரகாசதி. வால்மீகி, see, we sometimes discount வால்மீகி the இதிஹாசம் as a ராமாயணம் as an இதிஹாசம். It has a lot of kavya aspects in it, and that's why it is called an adikavyam. Not many people go back and refer to it. Whereas Anandavardhana gives us beautiful shlokams from both Mahabharatam and Ramayana. Ravi Sankranta Saubhagyaha Tushara Avrita Mandalaha Chandramaha Na Prakashate. Chandrama, the moon, Na Prakashate, it is not shining. Why? Ravi Sankranta Saubhagyaha. It is dawn here. So in the Ushak Kalam, the Surya Sankranta Saubhagyaha, because the sun is slowly rising, the sun's prakasham, the Surya's prakasha, Surya prakasha is much more than the Chandra prakasha. So the Surya prakasham, so Ravi Sankrantena, so Ravi Sankranta Saubhagyaha means Sankrantam Saubhagyam Yasya Saha, Ravina Saubhagyam Sankrantam, Sankrantam means Tiraskritam. So yasya saubhagyam, yasya chandrasya saubhagyam tiraskritam asti kena suryena. The sun removes the beauty of the chandra. In the morning, when the surya udaya is going to happen, even during arunodayam, when you look at the surya, the moon on the other side, the moon doesn't have so much of prakasham. So chandrama na prakashate. Why? Ravi sankranta saubhagya. Its beauty has been removed by the sun here. Tushara avrita mandala. Not only that, imagine Hemanta Ritu or Shishira Ritu, where there is the panimbo, that is dew, yeah, dew or a light snow. So tushara avrita mandala, the moon is completely its circle is covered with frost, no? That frost is tushara. So tushara avrita mandalaha, chandrasya mandalaha, vritta roopa, vrittakaram, tusharena avritaha. It is covered by frost. It looks like nishvasa andhaiva adarshaha. Beautiful upama that he gives here. Adarshaha is a mirror. You take a hot bath and then you look at the mirror in the immediately after that hot bath, the mirror will be completely covered with the frost, right? What is it called? And oru padinjirukum adula nishwasa andaiva. If you take your glasses and you blow on it, it will become completely, you cannot see through that glass, so it will be clouded. So nishwasena yatha adarshaha, nishwasena yatha andaha bhavati tatha chandramaha na prakashate. So you know that there is a mirror there, but the smoke or the steam has clouded the mirror, so it seems as if you cannot see, or the mirror cannot see. Nishwasa andhaiva andaha drishti rahityam. So you cannot see there is a padinjirku mele. There is a layer of steam on that mirror. So tatha chandramaha na prakashate. Because the prakasham of Surya has overcome the chandra kanti, and the chandra is also covered with frost. Tushara avrita mandalaha chandramaha. निश्वास अन्धः आदर्शः इव न प्रकाशते. इट डजंट शाइन लाइक हाउ द मिरर कैनॉट शो यू एनीथिंग इफ इट इज कवर्ड बाय दैट स्टीम. दिस इज ओनली दैट वर्ड अंध इज द अत्र अंधशब्दः एव अत्यंत तिरस्कृतम्. अत्यंतं तिरस्कृतम्. तिरस्कृतम् मीन्स यू कंप्लीटली नेगेट दैट द वाच्यार्थ. सो इट इज क्लियरली लाइक लक्षण टोटली. सो अंधः अंधः द वाच्यार्थ ऑफ अंध इज दृष्टिराहित्यम्. देर इज नो साइट. बट अचेतन वस्तुनः आदर्शस्य दर्पणस्य दृष्टि असंभवात् अथवा दृष्टिराहित्य असंभवात्. सो इट इज एन अचेतन वस्तु. इट कैनॉट इट इज नॉट अ सेंशिएंट बीइंग फॉर इट टू लूज इट्स साइट फॉर इट टू बी एन अंध. सो द मुख्यार्थ बाध हैपेंस हियर. यू गो टू द लक्ष्यार्थम विच इज मानिन्य युक्तम. बट दट व्यंग्यार्थम इज मोर इंटरेस्टिंग वेर इन अ मिरर इट इज नॉट एज इफ इट कंप्लीटली is gone, right? But you can sort of see the faces also. It is not completely andha, nishwasa andha. Just if you blow, there is a, you can also view your image in the mirror. That asadharana vichayatvam, there is a very unique colorlessness. It is a opaque thing. It becomes very translucent. That's the word I should say. No, asadharana vichayatvam. That is your vyangyartha. And it is not useful to look at your face also. That is the anupayogitvam also is a vyangyartha. The chandrama, there is no use for this chandrama now. It is not going to give shungara rasam. It is not an uddipanam. So maybe he is trying to say shantarasam. I am not sure what the dhvani is. For that, we will have to look at the context in Ramayana. Ravi Sankranta Saubhagyaha तुषार आवृत मंडल निश्वास अंधैव आदर्श चंद्रमान प्रकाशते. दैट वाज पदगतम. दिस इज वाक्यगतम वेर द होल टेक्स्ट इज गोइंग टू बी मेनी वर्ड्स आर नेगेटेड एंड यू आर गोइंग टू द लक्ष्यार्थम एंड विज्ञार्थम. गगनम च मत्तमेघम धारा लुलित अर्जुनानि च वनानि निरहंकार मृगंकाः हरन्ति नीलापि निशाः. निशाः नीला निशाः हरन्ति. नीलाः निशाः द डार्क नाइट्स आर हरन्ति. दे आर अट्रैक्टिव. गगनम मत्तमेघमपि और मत्तमेघम च धारा लुलित अर्जुनानि वनानि च निरहंकार मृगंकाः अपि निशाः नीलाः निशाः हरन्ति. द स्काई इज फिल्ड विथ क्लाउड्स विच आर ड्रंक. मत्तमेघम इट्स सो मत्तमेघम मीन्स इट इज जस्ट गोइंग दिस वे एंड दैट वे. सो देर इज टू मच ऑफ विंड. सो द क्लाउड्स आर एज इफ इट इज एज इफ द क्लाउड्स आर एक्टिंग इन अ वेरी ड्रंकन. दे आर इन अ ड्रंकन स्टेट. सो द स्काई इज फिल्ड विथ क्लाउड्स विच आर ड्रंक. सो मत्त मेघम गगनम धारा लुलित अर्जुनानि वनानि. वनानि फॉरेस्ट्स हैव अर्जुन ट्रीज. द वुड्स ऑफ अर्जुन ट्रीज. अर्जुन इज अ टाइप ऑफ अ ट्री. धारा लुलितानि अर्जुनानि. इट इज बीइंग थ्रैश्ड बाय द रेन. यू नो द रेन कम्स एंड कंप्लीटली इट इज द ट्रीज विच गेट अफेक्टेड फर्स्ट बाय द विंड एंड द रेन. सो धारा धाराभिः वर्षाभिः लुलितानि अर्जुनानि यत्र तादृशानि वनानि. तथापि निरहंकार मृगांकः. मृगांकः चंद्रः अहंकार रहितः अस्ति. ही डज नॉट हैव एनी गर्व रहितः. चंद्रन द मून डजंट हैव एनी अहंकार. मीन्स इट इज नॉट शाइनिंग इन सच अ ग्रेट मैनर. तथापि नीलाः निशाः द डार्क नाइट्स स्टिल आर अट्रैक्टिव. सो द आइडिया इज द वर्ड्स हियर मत्त एंड निरहंकार are being attributed to a achetana vastu, whereas these are all chetana vishayatva. So mattatvam or being intoxicated is a chetana vishayaha. The same way ahankara rahityam or garva rahityam is a chetana vishayatva. But it is being attributed to an achetana vastu, which is gagana megha and mriganka, the chandra. So there is a mukhyartha bhadam, badhaha. Then you go to the lakshyartha. So paritaha brahmanam is for mattaha. So it keeps moving here and there, just like an intoxicated person is not steady in his walk. In the same manner, these clouds are also moving this way and that way, where it is very dangerous. That is your it's doing something which is not conducive for shringaram. See, for shringaram, the uddipana vibhava should be something which should kindle. So purna chandraha. Where gaganam mattam, no, instead of mattamegam, if you can't feel love during a torrential rain, right? It should be a nice small drizzle, or the clouds should be the clouds should not keep moving here and there, and there should not be a tornado there. Nobody will feel love during a tornado or a hailstorm. So these are all not, even though they are not Uddipana Vibhava, they still, Neelapi Nishaha Haranti, they are attractive. It's the whole point. So it is the Megham that is moving here and there. Mattatvam is Atyanta Tiraskritam here, where it is only a Chetana Vishayatvam. Because the Megha is an Achetana Vastu, you just say that it is moving here, this way and that way. The Vyangartha that you, excuse me, Vengyartha that you come across is asamanjasa karitvam, means doing things that are not intelligent. So in a night, the night is attractive even though it prompts you to do things which are not really clever. So maybe he's trying to say that. Nirahankara mrigankaha also, garva rahitaha is the vachyartham. And garvatvam, garva being arrogant is a chetana vishayam. So we go to the lakshyartham of malinyam. Just like the previous where we saw nishvasa andha iva, and the same malinyam lakshyartha you take where the moon does not have any prakasham, prakasha rahityam. Even then it is beautiful. The paradhinatan ezhudirken. See, if you have an ahankaram, You are not dependent on others. You want to be dependent on yourself. Here, if the moon is completely Purnima, then it has so much of ahankaram, it is not dependent on anything else for its prakasham. Even if the moon does not have any prakasham, it is dependent, because now it is dependent on the night to attract the people. It cannot attract people on its own. That is why paradhinata is a vengyartha here. I hope you get that. Next is vivakshita anyaparavachyadvanehe bhedav. Asam lakshya krama dyotyaha, krama udyotya, udyotaha. Asam lakshya krama udyotaha, kramena dyotitaha paraha. Vivakshita abhideyasya dvanehe atma dvidamataha. Vivakshita abhideyasya, this is an abhidamuladvani where asamlakshya krama vyangya and samlakshya krama vyangya. So asamlakshya kramena udyotaha. Yasya kramaha na samlakshyate. The example we usually give is where you keep hundreds of lotus leaves, you have one sharp long needle and you poke from the first leaf. Immediately the next second, without any gap, it immediately comes out through the other side. Even though there is a krama of going after leaf one, then leaf two, then leaf three, then leaf four, and so on and so forth till leaf 100. Even though there is a process, that process is not noticed. It is so fast that it is not noticed. They did not have the modern technology of slowing down everything or making it fast. Times 2, times 0.5 was not there. So asam lakshya krama udyotaha. Yaha kramena dyotitaha paraha. If an artham, this is about vyangyartha. Vyangyartaha yatra udyotaha, where it is highlighted and the process is not easily noticed. Asam lakshya kramaha. The next division is kramena dyotitaha. There is a process with which it is noticed. The vyangyartha, it is noticed. That is paraha, that is dvitiyaha. that is the second division. Vivakshita abideyasya dvanehe atma dvidha mataha. So vivakshita nyaparavachya dvani is has two classifications. Mukhyataya prakashamanaha vyangyaha arthaha dvanehe atma. The atma of dvani is that vyangya artha which shines forth as very important. Such a vachyartha apekshaya kaschit alakshikramataya prakashate kaschit kramena iti dvidha mataha. It's an explanation for the karika. So sometimes the process is seen, sometimes the process is not seen. Tatra, in that asamlakshikramadvani is your rasadvani. So rasa bhava tad abhasa tad prashantyadir akramaha dvanehe atmangi bhavena bhasamano vyavastitaha. So dvanehe atma angi bhavena, atmangi bhavena, it shines forth as the atma. Angi bhavena bhasamanaha dvanehe atma iti vyavastitaha. Rasa bhava tadabhasa means rasa bhasa bhava bhasa tat prashanti adi, so which means bhava shanti, bhava udaya, bhava sandhi, bhava shamalata. All of these are there in Chaturthollasa in Kavya Prakasham. Okay, each one he has given an explanation as to how rasa pratiti happens, rasa dhvani, bhava dhvani, rasa bhasa dhvani, everything he's given a definition there. Here he won't go much into those details nor give any udaharanam for us. So his focus will be different because he has to move to the difference between rasa dalankaram and rasa dhvani. So the word rasa itself means abhivyajyate or rasyate iti rasaha. Rasyate, that which is enjoyed. The word itself establishes the Anandavardhana's dhvani paksham, where it is an abhivyajyate or dhvanyate, that which is being suggested. So for the discussions, you can go to Kavya Prakasham, where he talks about how utpadyate or it is pratiyate, all of these are there. There are bujyate, there are different types of rasa nishpatti that he talks about, and then he refutes all of them and establishes Anandavardhana's abhivyajyate, or that which is suggested. That is rasa. That is the process with which rasa is experienced. Okay? From vibhava, anubhava, and vyabhichari bhava. So abhivyajyate adava rasyante iti rasaha. Rasadihi arthaha hi sahaiva vachyena sahaiva avabhasate sacha angitvena avabhasamanaha dvanehe atma. Rasadihi arthaha, the rasa etc. are all avabhasate, they shine as if along with vachyam, vachyena sahaiva, as if it is that is immediately, that is the asamlakshakramam. The moment I say a shlokam, you immediately understand that rasam. So vachyena sahayeva avabhasate atava sahaiva avabhasate parantu rasadvanihi angitvena eva asti. Angitvena yatra bhavati tatraiva dvanehe atma iti svikrataha natu angabhutataya angabhutaschete rasaha rasavad alankara iti svikrihate. Now here rasaha, let me just give you a small explanation of what each and everything is. Rasa are either eight rasas according to Natya Shastra, or there is an interpolation where shantopi navamo rasaha, the ninth rasa is also shantam. Shringara, hasya, karuna, raudra, veera, bhayanaka, vibhatsa, adbhuta, shantakyaha, rasaveda, navakramat. Bhava are sthayi bhava, which are eight. Vyabhichari bhavas, which are 33 in number. And then rasa bhasa, bhava bhasa, these are all each. So abhasaha means ishad bhasate. A can be a suffix which is used for ishadarthe also. So ishad bhasate iti abhasaha. So rasa eva bhasate. Natu sakshat sampurnataya rasaha bhasate. Kintu rasa eva abhasate iti rasa bhasaha. So it is an anauchitya pravritti where the person who talks about that Shringara rasam that he experiences the person who talks about that is an anauchitya prakriti. That is, he is not the proper person, where he cannot, his love is not reciprocated by the other person. That is one type of Shringara Abhasam. The other type is Tiryag. Animals and birds which experience love, and if the poet has described that, like in Kumara Sambhavam, Madhudvireva Kusumaika Patre Pavo Priyam Swam Anuvartamanaha. When Vasant Ritu comes to the forest, even the animals in that forest start behaving in a very different manner, because they did not expect the spring season to come at a time like this. It was a sudden appearance of the spring season. And even the animals felt the effect of that spring. Madhu dvirepa kusumaika patre pava upriyam swam anuvartamanaha. Dvirepaha, even the bee, it drank nectar from one single flower along with its beloved, along with the female bee. It's like drinking from one juice, no? With two straws. Like that, the bee and its beloved drank nectar from one flower. Kusumaika matre. So that is a rasabhasam, because it is not a nayaka and a nayika. So that it is still called dvani atma, the dvanehe atma, because even rasabhasam has that quality of rasyate iti rasabhasaha. Even that is being enjoyed. Rasyate iti karanate rasabhasasyapi rasadvani dvanehe atma iti prakatitaha. So bhava bhasaha are in the same manner. If it exists in an anauchitya prakriti, it is not an appropriate person who experiences those bhava. And such a shloka is revealed, that is bhava bhasam. Bhava shanti is a stopping of a bhava, where the bhava is completely stopped. Bhava udaya is the rising of a bhava. Bhava sandhi is where two bhavas are coexist together. Bhava shabalata is where many bhavas exist together. Now rasavad alankarasya rasadvanehe cha bhedaha, where he wants to say how rasavad alankara is based on vachya and vachaka charutvam, whereas dhvani, rasadvani, is vyangyartha. Okay, so idanim rasavad alankarat, it is a kramapraptam, because he said about rasadvani, he has to give a differentiation between rasadvani and rasavad alankara. Alankara means there is something else which is a vyangyartham, and the rasam becomes a vachyam, and it is expressed in the shloka itself. So idanim rasavad alankarat अलक्ष्यक्रम द्योतनात्मनः ध्वनेः विभक्तः विषयः इति प्रदर्श्यते. अलक्ष्यक्रम व्यंग्य ध्वनि दट वी सॉ, विच इज रसध्वनि भावध्वनि भावाभासध्वनि एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. दिस रसवद अलंकार इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दट सेट ऑफ ध्वनि वी सॉ एज अलक्ष्यक्रम. विभक्तः विषयः, इट इज अ सेपरेट सब्जेक्ट मैटर. वाच्यवाचक चारुत्व हेतूनां विविधात्मनां रसादिपरता यत्र सद्वनेहे विषयः मतः. दिस इज नॉट, ही इज एक्चुअली डिस्क्राइबिंग हाउ रसादिहि रसादिपरता अलंकाराणाम् अस्ति. सो यत्र काव्ये वाच्यवाचक चारुत्व हेतूनां विविधात्मनां वाच्यवाचक चारुत्व हेतूनां, विच इज गुण अलंकार रीति एक्सेट्रा. All of these, there are different types of this vachya. Vachya is vachyartha, artha. Vachaka is shabda. So artha charutvasya hetu is artha alankara. Vachaka charutva hetu is shabda charutva hetu, shabda alankara. So shabda alankaranam, artha alankaranam cha vividhatmanam etesham yatra yasmin kavye rasadi parata asti, where they follow that angi rasam, that pradhana rasam, that is dhvani. In that kavya dhvanehe vishayaha mataha, sa kavya, the saha, saha ityukte that kavya is dhvani vishayaha mataha. Tat kavyam dhvanehe vishayaha iti mataha. Pradhane anyatra vakyarthe यत्र अङ्गं तु रसादयः काव्ये तस्मिन् अलङ्कारो रसादिः इति मे मतिः. देर् आर् डिफ्रेण्ट् डेफिनेशन्स् फार् प्रेयो अलङ्कार, समाहित अलङ्कार, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, बट् मे मतिः आनन्दवर्धन एस्टाब्लिशेस् इन् सेस् प्रधाने अन्यत्र वाक्यार्थे यत्र अङ्गं तु रसादयः. वाक्यार्थे मीन्स् व्यङ्ग्यार्थ, द वाक्यम्, इट्स् तात्पर्यम्, इट्स् विवक्षा. If the viviksha of the kavi, if the beauty of the poetry lies elsewhere, pradhane sati, anyatra sati, anyaha arthaha pradhanataya yatra vartate, angam yadi rasadayaha, yatra angam, rasadayaha tu angam, and rasa becomes an anga or a subsidiary thing to that main pradhana vyangyartha. In that, rasadihi alankaraha iti mehmatihi. I will treat those rasa etc. as an alankara, not as dhvani or atma. Okay? Yadyapi rasadalankarasya anyaihi darshitaha vishayaha, even though many people have shown rasadalankaram before, tathapi yasmin kavye, in that kavyam, प्रधानतया अन्यः अर्थः, प्रधानतया अन्यः अर्थः वाक्यार्थीभूतः, तस्य च अङ्गभूताः ये रसादयः, ते रसादेः अलङ्कारस्य विषया इति मामकीनः पक्षः. बिकास् देर् आर् मेनी डिफरेण्ट् वेस् आफ् सेयिङ्ग् दट् भामः हेज़् अ डिफरेण्ट् डेफिनेशन् फार् प्रेयो अलङ्कारम्. हि जस्ट् सेस् वेर् देर् इस् अ प्रशंसा, it is where there is a chatu vakyam, it is a preya alankara, whereas here the preya alankara is very specifically where the rasa has become an angam or a bhavam has become an angam, that is preya alankaram for anandavardhana. So many people have defined rasavad alankara in many different ways. Yadyapi rasavad alankaraha rasavara alankarasya vishayah anyaihi darshitah, even though it has been shown by others, yasmin kavye, in that kavyam where anyaha artha pradhanataya asti vakyarthi bhutasya, vakyarthi bhutaha anyaha artha pradhanataya vakyarthi bhutaha vyangyarthataya bhasate. If there is another artham which shines forth as a vyangyartha and as important, and the rasa etc., angabhutaha ye rasadayaha, rasa has become an angam or a subsidiary factor there, it is not the primary factor, te rasadehe alankarasya vishayaha iti mamakinam. I think it is a rasavad alankara. As an example, he says tadyatha, that rasa, where rasa becomes an angam, chatushu preyo alankarasya vakyarthatve api rasadayaha angabhutaha drishyante. Chatu vakyam is a priya vakyam, something which you say in order to get the other person to look at your point of view, to try to convince the other person, you use certain very clever usages or prashamsaparam. In that, chatushu preyo alankarasya vakyarthatve, preyo alankaraha means preyan alankaraha, preyo alankaraha, where another a bhavam becomes an angam to another bhavam. So if a bhava becomes a angam, then it is preyo alankara. Vakyarthi bhutatve, vakyarthatve api rasadayaha angabhutaha. Even though you have a preyo alankara there, the dhvani, the vengyartham will be something else. We are going to see examples of it, so don't worry if you don't find it. Or you can look at fifth Panchamollasa, where he has dealt with each and every of these alankaras. Urjasvi alankaram is where rasabhasa and bhavabhasa are angabhutaha. Something else is a angi pradhanam. Samahita alankaram is where bhava shanti is an angam. The rest, bhavodaya, bhava santi and bhava shabalata, are known as bhava santi alankara, bhava shabalata alankara and bhavodaya alankara. They don't have a different name. Only these three have different names. So preyo alankara is that which is more desired than the regular shabda alankara and artha alankara. That is why it is called preyana athava priyataraha. It is more dear. So preya alankara, if you cannot do rasadvani, at least you have to have some Prayo Alankara or Urjasvi Alankara, something like that, which is much better than having just a Kavyam, which has only Shabda Alankara and Artha Alankara without any beauty like Rasam, Rasabhasam, etc., etc. Okay? So, Pradhane Anyatra Vakyarthe Yatra Angam Tu Rasadayaha Kavye Tasmin Alankaro Rasadihi Iti Mematihi. This Rasavad Alankara or Rasadir Alankaraha is divided into two, Shuddhaha, Sankirnaha. First one is Shuddham. The second example is Sankirnam. Shuddham means where only one rasam or one bhava is an Angabhuta, takes on the role of a secondary, that is Angam. Whereas in Sankirnam, there will be two or three rasas mixed together. You might have read in your first, what is that? In Auchitya Vicharam, where you had Shringara, Adbhuta, etc., etc., mixing, you can take examples of that also. Okay, we'll stop with this. Any doubt?